Today I'd like to show you guys a quick tutorial on how to recreate one of the mechanics in Thief, where if you are within a light, you are more visible to the guards than if you are hidden within the darkness. So as you can see, our string output shows we are hidden or we are inside the light, and the same happens when we get behind these crates or if we are standing, you know, outside of the shadow. So let's go. Okay, so let's get started. So we have our own C++ character, called H character, and it actually derives in this case from another custom character, which is S character. But don't worry about this. You can just use like the third person template or the first person template. That's all fine. Just make sure you override the tick function. Let's step into this and we'll have a super good tick. So this is all like basic stuff. You'll have this in your first person or third person template as well if you selected a C++ option. So the goal of this first part is to get a Boolean to check whether or not we are within any lights or in no lights, basically. So let's get started by iterating all of the lights, because we need to know if we're within the radius. So let's have a look. Get all actors of class. Oh wait, actually this will be in U gameplay statics. Get all actors of class. So as the name might make you suspect, it will get you all of the actors of the class. It's very obvious. So we're looking for all of the point lights at this point. So we'll go for a point light because it's an actor type. That's why it's the A and not a U. The U prefix will be for like components and that sort of stuff. So a point light, and we need to get the static class. And finally, we need to specify an array that this function will fill, and it needs to be of type actor pointer. So we'll call this point lights, because that is what we're looking for. Point lights. All right. And now let's iterate over all of these point lights. Actually, we can use a range-based for loop, which is a little different from your usual, like this, like point lights. I'll just type both of them out. It's nice to have a bit of a comparison. So there we go. And a range-based for loop would be something like this. Actor. And we would specify the point lights. There we go. So since we're dealing with actors, unfortunately we can't like get the point lights straight out of this. So even though we're using a range-based for loop, which this is a range-based for loop, it's a little different than this. We still need to do a simple cast. So let's go and point lights. Well, let's just call it light, simple enough. And we need to cast it to the type we're interested in, which is going to be a point light. And there we go. And of course, just, you know, for sanity check, just check if it's if. We don't want to fail on this. And the first thing we want to do, actually, we can just delete this. If you prefer this, it would be fine as well. You could just do a point light. Light and actually do cast a point light. You would have something like point lights, and you would just have it within brackets. It's very similar. It's just nice to, especially if you already have the right type, then this is actually really, really nice. In a case, since we just have to do the casting anyway, you know what? I'm gonna go for the traditional way. So people might be more familiar with. And since we don't have the benefit of having the correct type already, we sort of like lose the benefit. So there we go. We will check the light. And one of the things is, nope. That was a visual assist warning that we're not interested in. point light component, we need to check this component because the point light itself, if you step into it using Alt G, you can see it doesn't have a lot going on. It's actually all inside the point light component. So let's see, let's check the attenuation radius. And if the thing we want to do first is we want to check if our character is within the attenuation radius of this light. So we're going to, and because we are in this character, we're going to do a simple distance check. So let's, and since we're a first person game, or at least that's the example, it's useful to, instead of using the actor location like this, that's actor rotation, get actor location, which would be the waist, because you know, the character is made of a capsule, and the capsule has a center pivot, which is it's in the center of the capsule. So that would be the waist of your character's mesh, approximately. And that's not very accurate for like gameplay in our case, because our head position will be much higher, and that's sort of like what we want to test against. So instead, we'll get actor eyes viewpoint, which will get two reference, like a vector reference and an rotator reference. So let's get eyes location, and F rotator is eyes rotation. There we go. Eyes location, eyes rotation. Okay. And so we'll be able to use this guy to check the distance against. So we have the light, and we know it's location. So like do light get actor location minus the eyes location, and once we have this, we can do a size, which will return the length, which is going to be the distance between us and the light. So let's see, distance, there we go. And now we want to compare this distance against the like attenuation radius we got here. So let's cut this and move this up here. There we go. So let's see, if we are if the distance is smaller than the attenuation radius of the light that we're comparing ourselves against right now, then we are possibly in the light itself. But there might still be, for example, an object between us and the light itself, like a crate maybe. So we might be in the shadow of the crate, so we're actually not being seen by this point light. So we have to do one more thing, and for this we do a line trace. So let's get the world and do a line trace single, and we have a few options here. In this case, we will use the visibility channel, so we need to do a line trace by channel. Okay, and we get the hit results. That will hold all of the data as the result, and we need to trace this either from the light to the eyes or from the eyes to the light. It's both going to be the same thing anyway. So let's go and trace from the light, or in this case from the eyes into the light. Let's get there. We go. And a trace channel is going to be visibility, which is often used for in this case visibility. And we would like to change some of these parameters. Let's see. It was a F collision query params. So let's create an F collision query params. And so we want to change a few values here. First of all, we want to ignore ourselves because we don't want to check if we are occluding ourselves, because that just doesn't make any sense. And another thing we would like to do is be trace complex. What this will do is it will trace against all of the triangles in the scene instead of against the rough approximations. And that's, you know, because the light shadow will use this, will trace against, you know, the triangles as well. So we want to have this precision of tracing against triangles instead of like rough bounding boxes in this case. Depending on your game's design, the trace complexity is not necessary. But in this case, we want to make sure that we get the most accurate trace. It is a little bit more expensive, so just keep that in mind. Okay, so we have the query params assigned as well, and the last parameter we don't need, and it's an optional because it, as you can see, it already has a default response provided. And so what we want to do is we want to make sure, or we want to check, like, did this have any blocking hit? Because if you look over here, it will return a bool, and the bool stands for, did we get any blocking hit, or was this, or were there no blocking hits? And if there is no blocking hit, so this specifies that it's a negative, then we are visible to the lights. And, you know, since we only want to check if we are visible to any light, it doesn't matter which light, and doesn't matter how much light is being cast on us, we just want to make sure that there is any light cast on us. We can just keep track of a simple boolean and say B is inside any light. And we want to make sure that this is available to blueprint. So we'll say blueprint read only, because we don't want blueprint to have any kind of like write permissions to this, because that would be chaotic. And we'll say this as player. So they can only read from this value, and because we are managing this in C++ writing. So let's set this to true. Now, of course, you know, this will be executed every single tick. So we want to make sure that before we execute this piece of code, every time we just want to reset ourselves to be false, so we can reevaluate if we are being seen by any light. And one more thing is, because we are in this little for loop, it's unnecessary as soon as we have been seen by a light to keep going. So we'll just break out of this loop. So as soon as this has been run, we'll just break, and we will no longer be iterating the rest of this these point lights. So for example, we have 20 point lights. After the 10th, we've been seen. Then we just break, and we save ourselves from checking another 10 point lights because we already set this one to true. Okay, so now we have this all set, and I think that should be all. So we can just go and compile. Okay, so we've loaded up a level that I'm going to use as this demo, and what I'd like to do is, first of all, we need to make sure we have a blueprint that is our player. So I've created this little folder, thief mode, and I'm going to derive from H character, there we go, and say bb thief player. Now this might look a little different from what you're expecting, but if you have like the first person or third person template, it will be similar enough. The only thing you need to care about is having some movement available, and that's just about it. So we can check in our tick, we can just check B is inside any light. This is the boolean that we're setting during our tick. And so let's just very quickly print this and just say, actually we could make this a select node. And if we plug this in, if this boolean is true, we'll print this text. And if it is false, we'll print this text. So let's say we are inside the light. There we go. And we said we are hidden. Oh. All right. And finally, to make it a little nicer, we'll do the same thing for our color. So if it is true, we'll select red because that would be bad to be seen. And if it is false, we'll set ourselves to green. Okay. And now all we need is a point light. So let's search for point light. Another nice trick is to do Control P. Oops. And search for point light. Oh, actually, that's wrong because it's not an asset. So in this case, we just do this. Okay. Now, as you can see, this is a very low fall off. So whenever we would be, you know, if we were just to play like this. Oh, actually, I didn't select the player yet. So we need to just go into find this in the browser. We'll just drag this in real quick. And we'll set ourselves to be out of possess. So this means regardless of what we're doing in our game mode or whatever, we'll just out of possess this character. And as you can see, we're already in this light because this attenuation radius is just enormous. But as you can see, this doesn't match with the visuals at all. So there's one last thing we need to do, and that is to change some of these properties. So we'll just uncheck use inverse square falloff. And now you can see like this is extremely bright because we set this is set to like 5,000. So let's tone that down a little bit. And let's set this guy instead of 8 to 1, which will make this falloff a little bit more harsh. And let's just tune this one down as well. So now as you can see, especially in this white wall, it's a lot harsher than it was before. So now that we've set up our player and I've set up this light, one thing I did add is set up this billboard so we can view it in the game. And I made sure that hidden in game is turned off. And then now when we play, we can see that, you know, it will both track if we are inside and out the outside of the light, and also if we are hidden from the light or if we are seen by the light. And this will track like trace against our face as we checked before. And there you go, that's it. So let me know what you thought of this tutorial, and maybe next time we can talk about the spotlight, the directional light, and maybe even create some AI to respond to this mechanic as well.